快。Yeah.
Mom, Dad's riding my bike.
Well, you're doing your routine.
I don't want to do it riding my bike.
Come on, show Grandma how you fight.
Mom!
Let him ride your bike, Stephanie. Dallas, go get your own bike. Dallas, go get your own bike.
Stupid.
Oh, Grandma's gonna love this tape. Grandma's really gonna love it.
I'm not gonna do any of it.
Yeah, show Grandma. Why did you leave them out?
Because.
Do a couple back springs. Very good.
There's Dallas trying to hide from Mommy.
Trying to hide. There he goes, out the door. Where'd he go? Say hi, Christy.
Hi.
Now let's go find Dallas. He's throwing a fit. Say hi to Grandma.
Hi.
Say hi, Dallas. There you are. Dallas, you better say hi. Dead, Dallas. Dallas, get out from under the bed.
He's under there. I know he is.
Get out now. The bed might fall. Come on, say hi.
No.
Come on.
No.
He talked, though. There is it.
Nope, you're not getting out. Hey, where'd you go?
He went downstairs.
Downstairs?
He went in the bathroom.
The bathroom? What's he doing in there? Come here. Wait, stop. Turn around. Go, I can't see you all.
Hi, Mom.
Hi.
Hi, Grandma.
Go stand out there by Stephanie.
Come on, Mom.
Is everyone ready to go to church? Christy, are you ready? Have you brushed your teeth?
Yeah.
Dallas, have you brushed your teeth?
Mm-hmm.
Go brush them. Stephanie, did you brush your teeth? Huh?
No.
Go brush them.
Hello.
Oh, are you not wearing your uniform?
Not my dress uniform.
Huh?
I'm wearing my working blues.
Well, I thought you were wearing your dress uniform.
Nah, I don't have my stripes or anything on it yet.
Oh.
Just plain Jane.
Oh, look at the house. It's a mess. There's Stephanie brushing her teeth. Say hi, Stephanie.
Hi.
Now look at the camera, huh?
Oh, you're too close.
Well, I'll focus.
There's James getting dressed. Everyone's getting ready except for John. He's playing at the computer.
Is he flying?
Yeah, he's flying. Christy, you look nice. It is cold. Maybe it'll get warm by noon.
Hopefully. Should I shower this?
It's not going to be cold inside the building. It'll just be cold walking to the building.
Tell me, get it out of the clothes.
Where is everyone? Hey John, how do you do this?
What?
Side.
Hi. Hi, Grandma. I'm gonna get on my jacket. Mom.
What?
Did you know some American tourists found the most secret lab in Britain? The cosmetics lab?
They did?
Yeah.
You really learn about a lot about this report, aren't you?
Speech.
Okay. Chris, let's go outside. Don't do that. You okay? I'm too cold out here. I'm going back in. He's crashing.
I'm a flat spin.
Gone.
Oh, he's crashing.
You got 3,000 feet. 2,000. 3,000. You're up there. You're okay.
Yeah. Return.
You got it back.
Got it back. Well, I almost went in the tank. I don't know how I recovered, man. I just got inverted. I'm supposed to pull down all of that. Am I going the other way now?
Yeah, I think so. Right away from it.
Just turn around the other way. All right, I'm going to go right side up this time. Get a little bit of a push.
Where'd he go? There he is. Ooh. A cute butt.
I want a picture of me in short tail bird legs.
I'm looking at that cute butt. Well, what time? It's 8:06, John. That's what this thing says. We got to leave in 24 minutes, and you haven't even had your shower yet.
Because that thing's way the heck off.
Is it?
Heck yeah, it's 8:04 on that one. That's 10 minutes fast.
It is not 10 minutes fast.
Sure is.
No, it's not. Put your hat on, James. Where's your hat?
Up there.
Oh, I just love a man in uniform. John, you gonna wear your uniform?
It's gonna be all right. My uniform, a pair of blue jeans and a shirt.
That's what I said. Are you gonna wear your uniform? You don't have to wear anything but jeans.
What's this?
I can't see. You move around too much. Here we are, going to church. John, I like your uniform.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello. No. We're still waiting for James to come down the stairs. Come on, James.
He's coming over.
She's James.
He's coming.
Here he comes.
What is it, 30 degrees
outside
tomorrow?
45. 45
degrees.
Thank you much.
What are you getting?
Huh?
Your jacket?
I'll just make sure I got everything.
Dallas, go get in the truck. Christy.
And
it's our
underwear.
Look at the
care.
Come here,
Stephanie.
See much. Oh, yeah, that's pretty.
Nuh-uh, there's just white stuff. Ooh.
Hey guys.
Hey, what's up?
Hi.
He's flying.
Hi, Mom.
Hi there.
Hey, 006.
Okay.
He was James.
Heaven will see.
Woo! On the backyard. Let's open up this line.
Is it off?
No.
On the backyard.
It's locked.
Still trying to get on Sister's bike, aren't you? Are you cold, Stephanie? Mm-hmm. I can't see you. Go back, stand back some more.
Mom, I'm gonna get my shoes on.
Go get your. Oh, you don't have shoes on?
Mm-mm. Mom, you're not gonna touch me.
What? Take your bike out in the front yard, and I'll. Video,
what?
Take your bike in the front yard and I'll video you riding the bike.
But how?
Just go out the back gate there.
Can I go in here?
No, go out the back gate and I'll go to the front door, okay? Staffy, go get your bike. Or, no, you got a dress on. You can't ride your bike.
Can we go get some shirts?
No. You rode your bike yesterday.
I can ride my bike with shirts. Just,
huh? Okay. Here's me.
Mom, don't take Kobe. He's stupid.
He's stupid? Why is he so stupid?
Because.
Go ride your bike, Dallas. Cold out here. We better put the bikes up.
Is this thing on?
Yes, it's on.
Oh. Woo. Mom, get your coat on.
I'm cold.
It's not cold.
Where'd Stephanie go?
She went. I think she went. She went over there. Oh no. I think she's just putting the bike.
On.
Don't tell me now, okay?
Zooming in. Play some more.
Like what?
Play what? Play Country Roads.
I get really you really think I'm gonna sing?
Yeah, sing.
Would you have another thing?
Come on.
I don't think so.
Come on.
Get James up here. If he sings it, maybe I will.
Okay, I'll be right back. Introducing James Ballou and John Hasseltine are going to sing Country Roads.
You need the thing keeps locking up on me.
Oh, it just...
Every time you take off, it just freezes.
I may have to make it.
All right. Yes, he goes gonna do it. Move,
oh,
Stephanie. James, doesn't he like this song?
I heard this song. It's all the words,
man. Oh, John knows the words.
Trailer for sale rent. Huh? Trailer for sale rent. Trailer for sale rent. Room selected. Oh. I'm gonna screw this up like the last one. It's been too long since I played these.
I'm gonna come.
Old song. Gotta get a good lead in. Oh, come on, John, I was doing the close-up on your fingers. Come on, do under the double eagle. I can't do it no more. My fingers, I can't. See, I ain't got nothing on them no more.
Try it.
They hurt.
Do it again.
I can't. Go
under
the
double eagle.
Oh, I can't do it. Sorry.
Come on.
I played myself out yesterday.
What was the song we did the other day?
Which one?
The one that I said, hey, that one's done.
Which one was that?
Cafe down the corner.
Oh yeah, the cafe down the corner.
Yeah, that's it. Can't do it no more. I never did know this song very well. And I ain't played it in 6 months, 8 months. So that does.
Do you remember that one that you sang at that banquet, John? The solo? What was that one?
I needed the music whenever I did that one. I just stick the music in front of my face so I could remember
what was that one called?
I don't remember.
The one by Billy Dean.
I don't remember.
This is Christy's room. Notice the beds are unmade. There's stuff all over the floor, all over the dressers. Look, there's a glass of pop, clothes on the floor. There's another glass, there's a coffee cup. Look at this room. It's a mess.
Okay.
Yeah, right.
Okay, I'm doing my speech for animal protection. Zoos may be protecting animals, but they're also killing them too. That's why I'd like to persuade you to believe that animals should be protected. The Metropolitan Magazine examined changes in zoos. Rather than keep them in tiny cages, they now keep them in their surrounding environment. Some of the biggest zoos captured over 300 animals, endangered animals. When they returned them, over half of them died from cultures. There was a polar bear stuck on a cliff. Some of the zoo's finest pets came to rescue him. He broke a leg, so they took him to the zoo. After his leg healed, they let him go. A month later, they found him slaughtered by vultures. I got interested in this topic from animal experimentation for cosmetics. Using animals for testing cosmetics can kill or injure certain animals. It's also dangerous for humans because some cosmetics are almost okay for animals, but can really damage people who use it. You can shut down these factories by using cosmetics that are not tested on animals. If you do this, they will have to go out of business. They will turn all the animals over to the Humane Society. Killing animals for the making of cosmetics is wrong. Most lipsticks are made of whale blubber. Some cosmetic makers decided to collect blubber from whales that are already dead, but other factories said that not many whales died. They thought they would go out of business if they didn't kill whales. That is why the Supreme Court outlawed whaling. Skinning an animal's fur is wrong. Why not use cotton or synthetic items? If you were a furry animal, would you want to be skinned for someone else's pleasure? Would you want to go around bald? I know I wouldn't. Did you know that it takes over 100 chinchillas for one chinchilla coat, 30 rabbits for one rabbit coat, 27 raccoons for one raccoon coat, 8 beaver for one beaver coat. Over 50 elephants are killed each year for their ivory tusks. How would you feel if you were being killed just for your teeth? How would you feel if your teeth were made into decorations or a pair of necklace? I know I would feel awful. Did you know that there's enough grains and beans in the world for everyone? The only problem is over half of all those grains and beans are fed to animals that are ready to be slaughtered. Over 17 million animals have been in factory experiments each year. In 1987, the nation's 1,260 registered research centers used 180,000 dogs, 150,000 cats, 61,900 primates, 500,000 guinea pigs and 500,000 rabbits. I don't think it's right for animals to be killed or injured. That's why I would like for you to believe that animals should be protected. That's it.
Very good.
Thank
when
you.
Do you give your speech?
Monday or Tuesday. And these are the...
So that trip to the library really helped, huh?
Yeah.
Who is that?
It was my dad. Wait.
What was he doing?
Mom, I got something to show you.
Can I?
What?
These are what the experiments do.
From Michelle.
Gillette
did that?
Yeah.
What Gillette. Did it do?
It shaved them and made them bleed.
Oh, where's that one about the dog?
The dog, okay. That's sad. The dog one?
Uh-huh.
I saved the page. Okay. This was before, and this was after.
Let's see if it'll zoom in.
Will it?
Oh, it's too blurry.
Let's get back.
How was it?
Mom.
Yeah, scoot way back. Let me try to zoom in. Where's before?
Before?
Okay, hold it straight up. See, skin and bones.
Terrible.
And they brought it back.
Yeah, and this is it.
Look at all that, skin and bones. Isn't that terrible?
Yeah, he was right before death. He would have died a month later.
Not even a month, I don't think.
No. It says here he would have died in about 5 days if they didn't come and rescue him.
Uh-huh.
Mom, can I go outside?
Yeah, go on.
I mean, not outside, but can I go play with my friend Michelle behind
well, don't be gone too long, because we got to leave in about, what time is it? We got to leave in 13 minutes to take James to the airport.
Okay.
This is what they do to rabbits in another one.
Mom, can I stay there while you guys go look?
No, you may not.
This is what they do to rabbits. They had mice.
They put mice in the cage?
Yeah, for experimentation and everything. And the rabbit itched itself all up until there's no more to itch.
Why, they want to see how much he'd scratch himself?
You know, it says here they were doing an experiment about if the animal would itch. Something like that.
Oh.
And this is what they do to monkeys in America and Great Britain. I can find it.
What do they do?
This is in America and Great Britain.
What do they do to it?
They put it in a machine. And it's in pain.
Huh, poor thing. Okay, let's go see if the guys are ready to go. You ready to fly a real plane yet, James? Huh?
Realistic enough for me.
Next time I'm on the plane.
Where are you flying at?
Front.
Oh, did you crash?
Can I? Can I do it?
What? I think I knocked my gear down for some reason.
Can I do it now? Mom, I play the airplane. Mom, I play the airplane.
Mm-hmm.
I craft.
You like flying with James?
I like the plane.
You hate to see him go?
I like the plane.
Dallas, you hate to see him go?
I like the plane. Yes.
Do you want James to stay?
Watch my takeoff here.
Dallas?
Perfect takeoff.
Dallas. Do you want James to stay?
I don't care.
You don't care?
Okay, I'll stay.
You'll stay?
Yay!
Oh, there's Chicago, right? You taking off from Migs Field?
Taking off from Migs Field.
You're not gonna stay here. You're supposed to get
Chicago.
Home. You're supposed to go.
I'm gonna head for, gonna break a little bit southeast here.
I wonder what Antwerp.
Midway.
You gonna hit the Midway? Dallas, move.
I wonder what that means.
Well, those really look like clouds.
Going on an airplane.
Too long to drive.
airplane goes fast.
Getting ready to go to the airport now. It's a little after 2. We're going to take James back. You know how hard it is to walk and carry this thing at the same time?
A little hard.
I'm gonna fall.
Hi, Mom.
Hello.
Mom, is that on?
Yes, it's on.
Is there a movie in there?
Yeah, we're at the airport.
What is it?
Don't.
What is it?
That's another tape.
Who's this?
It's Stephanie.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, where's Stephanie?
I don't know.
That's cute. Say hi, James.
Looking around, and I'm the announcer. I'm talking now. Yeah. I'm the announcer, and Mama is carrying my dad and me. And my brother got in the way.
Dallas, sit down.
And now go dancing in a weird way.
There's Christy acting like a little lady.
Yep. And Dallas crossed by her. And here's me.
Kids, sit down.
Okay, let's get something from the snack bar.
What?
Let's get something from the snack bar.
Wouldn't you rather wait and get the big get one of it somewhere else?
No.
What's that? Yeah.
Hi, Mom.
Go sit down. Go sit down. Go sit down.
morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this week's recruit graduation ceremony. Following today's review, the companies will depart to their compartments. You can meet your recruit at the North Porter Grinder next to the visitor center shortly thereafter. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Companies will arrive in the following order. Company 115.
It's 115.
The band is on.
Company 116. 7. Company 118. Company 119. Company 120. Company 121. Company 122. Base. Section leaders, fall out and collect powder garments. May I have your attention, please? It is requested that once the review has started, you do not pass in front of the review stand. Also, while picture taking is permitted from the stands, please do not move onto the parade deck for this purpose. The photographers you will see today are the official photographers of the command. Thank you.
So these five people in the band are 919, right?
Yep.
And the choir? Did they say the choir?
Yeah.
Not him.
anything they've ever seen cave in the uniform. Oh, yeah. Sure does. Yeah, no cap, no doubt. Send it to his mom. Sure wasn't about to start hollering. Oh, yeah, that's the old time stuff.
Is that where they flip them around?
White booties. Left leg is strong, I'm telling you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the recruit, drill team. Will the guests please rise? Recruit Training Command, Great Lakes, arriving. Naval Training Center, Great Lakes, arriving. Organization Transition Executive, Naval Air Systems Command, arriving. Guests may be seated.
standing behind the can.
Will the guests please rise? Chaplain Spangenberg will now give the invocation.
Let us pray. O Lord our God, we have cause to call upon your name in every season and at all the important moments of our lives. Today we invoke your name as we honor the young men who stand before us on the occasion of their achievement. As we recognize and praise them, may they rededicate themselves wholly anew to the standards of honor, commitment, and courage in their service to the nation we love. Give them renewed strength, protect them from all harm, and guide them all the days of their lives unto the glory of us all and the glory of your name. Amen.
The guests may be seated. Historically, it is at this point when the commanding officer will issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Following this, the unit commanders will face about and relay these orders to their troops. At this time, it is being used to give a visual demonstration of the chain of command.
Good morning, Senator Hewitt. I'll have permission granted to commence review.
The Sailor's Creed. Ladies and gentlemen, the Recruit Blue Jackets Choir. Thank you.
performance. Split drill team under the able leadership of seamen and recruits, Lerma and Leisure, I'm sure would make the official Marine Corps drill team in Washington very nervous. The band's medleys were spectacular, and the choir, all I can say is that that's the best I've ever heard Anchors Away sung, and I'm sure that you all want to be marching home, so we'll get on with this thing. But I think it's important for everyone here to realize that this Triple Threat Company, which is graduating this week, is not a separate cadre. These are recruits who have only been together for a few weeks and, in fact, put this routine on for the very first time after only 6 weeks together. I think that's a remarkable achievement. In addition to all that,
Kelly, I don't know. I've never been to one of these things before. I think those are honors.
Good morning. I'm Captain W. O. King, Jr., Commanding Officer, Recruit Training Center, Great Lakes. On behalf of Admiral Mike C. Gaston, Commander Naval Training Center, Great Lakes, welcome to this morning's Recruit Graduation Pass and Review. Special welcome to our reviewing officer, Rear Admiral William E. Newman, U.S. Navy, and to the parents, wives, family, and friends who have come here to share this significant milestone with their new sailor. The Recruit Training Command, which is part of the Great Lakes Naval Training Center, the oldest and largest naval training center in the United States, has transitioned over 3 million of America's youth from civilian to sailor since opening its doors nearly 83 years ago in 1911. This year, the Naval Training Center complex will provide the Navy with nearly 70% of its newest sailors, as well as initial technical training to thousands of naval personnel each year as they prepare to go to the fleet. Today, our ships and shore stations are manned by top-quality sailors like the ones you see before you. As our military and Navy right-sizes in response to our changing world, our challenge in the future is to preserve that quality and the readiness of our naval forces in what promises to continue to be an era of predictable change with often unpredictable results. Whatever lies ahead, the Navy will continue to do the job well, carrying on the traditions of patriotism, integrity, and courage of the men and women who have served before us. Today, as we welcome our newest shipmates, your Navy and Marine Corps team continue to maintain vigilance in forward positions throughout the world, not only to show our flag and be ready to respond if freedom is once again challenged, but to provide humanitarian assistance wherever needed and underscore the meaning of human dignity. These new sailors are ready to graduate and go to the fleet to serve in our ships, aircraft, and submarines. They have earned the right to be called sailors and to wear the uniform recognized throughout the world as a symbol of freedom. The United States Navy, together with other Department of Defense components, is commemorating the 50th anniversary of World War II.
This celebration began December 7, 1991, coincident with the Pearl Harbor commemoration, and will end September 2, 1995, exactly 50 years after the signing of the formal surrender documents on board the USS Missouri. Our Navy and Marine Corps team will continue to honor the veterans of World War II and acknowledge their sacrifices. We will also remember the tremendous contribution Americans made at home supporting this unprecedented effort. If there are any World War II veterans here today, would you please stand or raise your hand? C. Gaston, Commander Naval Training Center, Drake Lakes. A native of Dalton, Georgia, Admiral Gaston holds a bachelor's degree from Tuskegee University and a master's degree from Marymount University. He is listed in current editions of Who's Who Among Americans and Who's Who Among Black Americans. Admiral Gaston served on the destroyers USS Buck and USS O'Brien and the guided missile destroyer USS Cunningham. He has commanded the guided missile destroyers USS Cochrane, USS Cone, and the guided missile cruiser USS Josephus Daniels. He has also served as Commander Field Command Defense Nuclear Agency in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm recruit training command welcome to distinguished naval officer and surface warrior, our boss, Rear Admiral Max C. Gaston. With Carrier Division 4. He has commanded Attack Squadron 195, Carrier Air Wing 9, and the combat store ship USS White Plains. He has also served as Commanding Officer Flight Leader for the Navy Flight Demonstration Squadron, the Blue Angels, and as Commander of Pacific Missile Test Center, Point Magoo, California. He has logged over 5,100 flight hours and more than 40 types of operational and flight test aircraft. Other assignments include Empire Test Pilot School in England, Head Air Launched Weapons Requirements Branch in the Office of the Chief Naval Operations, Naval Air Systems Command Programs Manager for Defense Suppression Systems, and Program Director of Air Warfare Programs at the Naval Air Systems Command Headquarters. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm recruit training command welcome to distinguished Naval Leader and Combat Aviator, today's reviewing officer, Rear Admiral Bill Newman. Recognition for the company is in the form of flags, which are carried as a visible symbol of superior performance in the four major competitive categories of academic achievement, military drill, personal appearance, and athletics. A company that attains superior marks in the four major categories of a specified level of achievement graduates with distinction and is awarded the title Color Company, earning a special flag in recognition of this outstanding performance. Three companies in this graduating group have earned this special status. Company 115, Company 117, and Company 122. Congratulations to all three companies on the job well done. I'll now present the honor recruits of the graduating companies of Recruit Training Command. Please hold your applause until all the recruits have been introduced. Senior recruit Andrew K. Pennington, Company 116, Bay City, Texas. Senior recruit Jermaine C. Miles, Company 117. Seaman Recruit Joaquin M. Havens, Company 118, Los Angeles, California. Seaman Recruit Ryan P. Toll, Company 119, El Paso, Texas. Seaman Recruit San H. Toko Kwan, Company 120, Garden Grove, California. Seaman Recruit Evan A. Heal, Company 121, Indianapolis, Indiana. Seaman Recruit Hans F. Olson, Company 122, Rochester, New Hampshire. Seaman Recruit Carl R. Cabbage, Company 919, San Diego, California. To each honorary group goes the traditional Navy congratulations of Bravo Zulu, which means congratulations, shipmates. Well done. Seaman Recruit William E. Richardson of Company 120 from Alexandria, Virginia, is this week's winner of the USO Award. Seaman Recruit Richardson, congratulations, shipmate, on a job well done.
Thank you.
ceremony. The guests may be seated. Please remain seated until the official party and the recruit company is without the parade. Thank you.